Welcome to Part 6 of UnityConnect training. As we learned in Part 1, UnityConnect can capture data using different methods. Other videos in this series explained how to transform data using the data file method. This video covers the remaining methods. We recommend that you move on to Part 9 if you are using the data file method. Typically, when using the serial data stream method, UnityConnect transforms data automatically. However, when you have a new lot number or test, the process is a little different. You'll know that UnityConnect has detected a new item because the reprocess button will have become active. We recommend setting up the new item in Unity Real-Time before transforming your QC data with UnityConnect. Part 2 of our Unity Real-Time training covers setup if you need more information. After configuring the new item in Unity Real-Time, click the Reprocess button. A notice appears. This lets you know that UnityConnect has detected the new item. Click OK. UnityConnect automatically displays the new items that need to be configured. In this case, it's a new lot number. Use the drop-downs to map the new code to the control that you set up in Unity Real-Time. Click Save and Close. UnityConnect transforms the QC data into a Unity-friendly format, and it's ready to be imported into Unity Real-Time. This is all that most customers need to know, and they can move on to Part 9. However, a small segment of customers should follow a different process than the one that was just described. Most laboratory systems output lot numbers. UnityConnect detects new lot numbers and prompts the user to configure the new lots. However, if your system does not output lot numbers, it outputs codes that do not change. This means that there's nothing new for UnityConnect to detect when a lot switch occurs. The Reprocess button never becomes active. You must reconfigure your software when a lot switch occurs. Reporting data for the wrong lot can result in undesired results. Your data may be rejected, or you could skew the peer group. Do the following to transform data in this case. Duplicate the new lot number in Unity Real-Time. Part 2 of our Unity Real-Time training covers duplication if you need more information. Return to UnityConnect. Click the Configure button. Navigate to the Lots tab and locate the existing control. Use the selectors to match the existing code to the lot that you set up in Unity Real-Time. Click Save and Close. You'll need to click the Watch button to restart the transformer. UnityConnect transforms the QC data into the correct format, and it's imported into Unity Real-Time. Continue your training by skipping to Part 9.